Hello, happy new year, welcome back to my channel. It's the end of January and we are about to head off to Rome. Woohoo! So we're at Stansted Airport.
Hey.
Last night, me and Connor watched the final of The Traitors.
Yeah, it was pretty intense, wasn't it?
It was really, really intense. So Harry won The Traitors. I really wanted Andrew to win.
I wanted Andrew to win too. But yeah. Harry played the best, I reckon, from the start to finish.
Yeah. He had people wrapped around his little finger as well.
He did. Molly proper fell for it, didn't she?
Oh, she did. If only she'd voted Harry out. She could have took half the money for herself or Jazz for the Faithfuls. But yeah, she stuffed up a bit. So it goes there, eh? It's a game. Are you going to apply for it for next year, Tom?
Help.
Just went on a really long walk to go to the loo, and the blooming loo was closed. So I still haven't been. My boys really do like looking at watches. Was that why, like, the emergency exit?
They took one look at us, they were like, these people are like cannon fodder.
That's what it feels like. Okay, we've just landed. It's actually really sunny.
Warm in the sun.
So we're on that flight with a whole bunch of school kids that are doing Rome. And the teachers were sat right in front of us. There were just teenagers everywhere. Oh, someone's dropped their teddy bear. So we're in Rome. There was a bit of a faff getting the car and driving all the way from Rome Airport to Rome City Centre. Oh my gosh, the streets were so stressful. But we made it. We're at our accommodation. We just woke up and it's Connor's birthday! Yay! That one's from Nana. Well, we're in Rome. It's pretty early in the morning. We've decided to try and go out as early as possible because the Trevi Fountain is our first location and we know that it can get extremely busy. What time is it? 7:30? I'm gonna head down this street. And yeah, it feels good. It's chilly, but not freezing. I'm hoping it'll warm up more to justify me only coming out with a hoodie on. Spending your birthday in Rome. Roman holiday. Oh, isn't that incredible?
Isn't it?
The Trevi Fountain. It really is impressive. Apparently, around 3,000 euros a day are thrown into the fountain by superstitious people making a wish, throwing their dreams upon the fountain's waters, but it is actually an official legal crime to be fishing the coins out of the fountain, so don't do it, no matter how tempting.
Yeah, I know, it's funny because that up there looks just like me.
Reckon?
Yeah.
But yeah, get a look at all those coins. As I said though, it is a crime to dig any of the coins out. It's hard to believe though that that's 3,000 euros a day, but apparently that is the average. Thank you. Right, so we're heading over now towards Vatican City, but just get a look at these pillars. I tell you, if walls could speak, I wonder what these pillars would tell you. What do you reckon, eh, Marcus? I mean, they look like they date back a shed long way. And what's with all the holes in the wall? I mean, was this some sort of battleground or execution site or something? It looks like a lot has gone down here. I'm kind of sorry that I don't have any information, but it looks incredibly impressive. All right, so it's Sunday, it's Connor's birthday. Happy birthday, Con! We're just having a little bit of a coffee.
I just bought a drink and I thought it was like orange juice.
Is that
a beer?
It is beer. Oh my gosh, it's 8 o'clock in the morning and Connor's inadvertently bought himself a beer that he just grabbed out of the fridge thinking it was orange. So he's got a cappuccino on the way to wash it down. Definitely a little bit brisk this morning, but I didn't want to wear my coat because it's actually going to warm up quite a lot. So I've got my really nice warm fleece on instead.
So this is a Fast and the Furious filming location where Vin Diesel drives his car into the water and he pushes a crane all around that stops this big bomb going into.
It was actually shot here?
Yeah, it's now.
From a historical point of view though, look at it, that's amazing. That's the St. Angelo Castile, so castle. I mean, yeah, it's just so impressive to actually see. We think this is also a location from the movie Spectre, James Bond, where Daniel Craig drives at night time at high speed and then ends up in the river. Yeah, I mean, those are the lanterns that light up the wall where Bond is driving along. See, the lanterns are still there. It's definitely it. All right, we are approaching Vatican City.
Always Marcus.
It's always Marcus. He bleeps, he's got to go back through. So, he always bleeps. There he comes. Suspicious, isn't he? Yeah. No matter where you go, you're this always bleeping. You get bleeped at the airport. I don't think you've ever walked through security.
Have you got anything to say? Anything to say?
Without being bleeped. Anyway, look at this. Look how the sun is shining on St. Peter's Square right now. Isn't it lovely?
Your belt has been made of like a heart shape material.
Yeah.
We're in the Vatican. What do you reckon, Mark?
beautiful.
Stunning, isn't it? Inside the Vatican. Look at that. So the Constantinian Basilica was built over what's believed to be the tomb of St. Peter way back in 326 AD. So we're leaving St. Peter's Square now, and I tell you what, there's a lot of like demonstrations going on here. There's people queuing up to go into St. Peter's Square. I don't quite know what it is that they're declaring, so I don't understand what the banners mean. There's nothing in English. Steps. Don't ask me why they're called the Spanish steps and not the Italian steps, given the fact we're in Rome. But yep, they are pretty famous. There's another little mini fountain. Aww. Any theories as to why they're called the Spanish steps? I haven't even looked up any facts.
I haven't either. If I had to guess, maybe the Spanish built them.
Apparently the Spanish steps are not called the Spanish steps in Italian. But they do feature in the movie Roman Holiday. These Spanish steps are host to many Italian traditions. So, there you go. Colosseum, we're about to go through security. Hopefully this time, Mark, you can clear security without leaping.
Yes, hopefully.
Alright, so we are now at the Colosseum. This is amazing. I mean, just look at it. It's absolutely incredible. So I came here in 2008 with Connor and Mum. Connor was only 8. And it's just exactly the same as it was, obviously. Really sunny now, you'd barely know it was January. It's really warm, look, I'm in a t-shirt. I can't believe it. It's so amazing to be standing here in this ancient, historical venue, site. You just can't really imagine what's gone down here.
All my words fall short. I got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude?
People fought to the death.
Can you try to picture how it actually was?
Yeah, so the bit before when the dude was like, do you want to go down?
That was the arena bit.
Yeah, we can do that after.